Hello Super Set Maniacs and welcome back to my channel. Ronnie Coleman versus Phil Heath is the main event of all the bodybuilding comparisons. Coleman is widely regarded as the best of all time and considered by many to be invincible. However, Phil Heath may be the closest in hoping to beat him in a comparison. YouTube is full of videos with photo comparisons between the two, but I don't think anyone has done a side-by-side video footage comparison for all the mandatories until now. Yes, in today's video, we're gonna have 1998 Mr. Olympia Ronnie Coleman versus 2011 Mr. Olympia Phil Heath. Their first Olympia wins and also some, if not their actual best shapes of all time. But this is not gonna be a photo comparison, but a side-by-side footage comparison for all the mandatory poses. So let's start with the front double biceps. First of all, I did some scaling, but this is quite difficult when we are talking about footage. The camera often zooms in or out and the angles are also different. Mainly, keep in mind that sometimes Ronnie will look smaller than in reality in comparison to Phil. This is a strong pose for both of them, especially in the beginning of their Olympia reigns. Look how tight both of their midsections are. Okay, so from top to bottom, Phil is winning the forearms. He's also got the longer biceps, but Ronnie's incredible peaky biceps are more impressive. Ronnie's got the better V-taper as he's got the wider clavicle and probably the bigger lats, but Phil wins the abs. Downstairs at the quad department, it's pretty tight between them. Ronnie had improved on his quads a lot since 1997, shocking the world with his overall downstairs development, and Phil has always been strong when it came to the quads. Overall, this pose goes to Ronnie for having the more impressive biceps and the better X-frame. Up next is the front lat spread, and this is usually Phil's least impressive pose, mainly because of his narrow structure and dominant arms that overshadow his lats. However, here in 2011 he had the best midsection in his entire career. It was tight and his abs were ripped. His legs were world class, so he looked pretty good in this pose. But Ronnie Coleman is one of the best of all time in this pose. He's wide, his lats are impressive, his midsection was tight here in 98, and of course, his quads were world class as well. Ronnie Coleman wins the front lat spread pose as well. Next pose is the side chest, and boy oh boy, this is a tough one. Phil Heath has that unmatched 3D roundness over Ronnie, but Ronnie has that paper thin skin in response. Phil's delts look more impressive here in my opinion, but Ronnie's got a smaller advantage at the chest area from the side, and I say from the side because from the front his domination is more obvious at this department. Phil's arms look more impressive to me in the side chest, so overall he's getting the point in this pose. And we turn to the back. Olympias are won from the back, they say, and it's gotta be true as these two have 15 Olympia wins combined. Just like I was mentioning earlier, Phil has that cartoonish 3D look and he is also very well balanced. Ronnie's got the thinner skin, which gives the impression that he is way more conditioned. Ronnie also wins downstairs here as he is definitely winning the glutes. He seems to be having the better hams and, surprisingly, he may also win the calves here. Upper body, it's true that looking at their backs, there can be a case for Phil to win, but Ronnie's peaky biceps are more noticeable than Phil's long-headed biceps from the back, so overall Ronnie Coleman wins this pose. Up next is the back lat spread, and just like in the front lat spread, Ronnie's got the width advantage over Phil. Phil presents some incredible details and he's got the more impressive traps. However, Ronnie's downstairs domination is obvious again. He is wider and he presents some incredible details through the back himself. So overall, he beats Phil here and wins both back poses in this comparison. Next pose is the side triceps, and the tricep department is the one where Ronnie was never one of the best. It's true, his triceps were nice and striated, but they never had the fullness like those of a Kevin Levroni, a Rolly Winkler, or Phil Heath. So yeah, Phil Heath is one of the greatest when it comes to this pose, so he beats Ronnie Coleman here in what is probably the easiest win in this whole comparison. Up next is the abs and thighs, and this is closer than I thought. Phil Heath in 2011 had a strong ab and thigh pose, as his midsection was tight and his abs were ripped, but Ronnie Coleman in 98 was very aesthetic, as we can notice here. But see guys, maybe in the pictures we could have missed this detail, but Ronnie's abs peel out in an odd way, and they also have that gap in the middle, which is very unaesthetic. It's true, Ronnie has the better lats, thus the better V-taper, but overall Phil Heath is the better man in this pose. Unfortunately, in 98, the most muscular was not a mandatory, so we don't have Ronnie Coleman hitting this pose in this particular posing round I used, so we're gonna have to rely on pictures for this last pose. In this hands clasped variation, Phil Heath looks incredible, but Ronnie is holding up good against that, isn't that right guys? I still think Phil's got the upper hand, as his delts, buys and tries look fuller and rounder, and his midsection looks better as well. Let's check out the crab variation as well. In these high quality pics we can notice Ronnie's thinner skin I was telling you about earlier. He's also got the better traps and the better chest, so in the end, I'm gonna call this last pose a draw. So in conclusion, before the most muscular, Ronnie was leading 4-3 against Phil, and even if I have given Phil the most muscular, meaning the score would have been 4-4, I still think that overall, Ronnie 98 was slightly better than 2011 Phil. So yeah, Ronnie may be the greatest, but Phil is definitely pushing him to the max in these comparisons, meaning that he could have done the same thing on stage against him. What do you guys think about this comparison? Let me know in the comment section below who's better, Ronnie 98 or 2011 Phil. Also like this video if you enjoyed it, and don't forget to subscribe for more videos like this. Thank you guys and see you next time.